Hello, natural resources. Welcome to our next section of forestry, our last section of forestry, forest management. So we'll talk about the importance of managing our forests in this section. We'll talk about some common practices used in forest management, and then we will send you off with a final project for forestry. So our learning targets, I can use information about a tree or forest to make informed management decisions, and I can explain and treat various tree or forest disorders. Now, you're probably wondering, what is forest management? Well, forest management provides care and attention to individual trees and ecosystems to ensure sustainable conditions. And remember, the three legs of our sustainability stool are social, economic, and environment. So when we are managing our trees and our forests, we need to make sure that we are meeting those three pillars of sustainability. So as you read this definition, think to yourself, what stands out? Why should we manage our trees and why should we manage our forests? Because trees and forests aren't necessarily the same thing. Trees are what make up a forest, but we can manage different trees differently than we manage a whole forest. That might not be the best idea, but that's definitely something we can do. So as you read that definition, hit pause, think about those three questions, and we'll move on from there. For me, what stands out to me about the definition is the word sustainable, and that's kind of why I highlighted that word, social, economic, and environment. We need to be thinking about more than just ourselves or the current needs when we are managing our trees and our forests. Why should we manage our trees? So that each individual tree is able to provide habitat for the wildlife and for our other natural resources. That's a big thing for me, at least. And also, why should we manage our forests? Well, forests are very important economic tool, but also environmental tool in our day-to-day lives. In the area that we live in here in Staples, there's lots of trees around, especially compared to other parts of the state, like our friends down to the south. So it's important that we manage them so this resource can be used and enjoyed for many years to come. Trees, however, can get sick, and these are called disorders, and they can cause different trees or forests to become destroyed by natural or unnatural causes. So best management practices are what we use to help overcome these and treat these. And we'll talk about forest disorders here in our end of the section project. So there's a couple of different management practices that we can utilize. First is even age management. And this is when we have forests with trees that are roughly the same age. Some harvesting methods we can use then are clear cutting, shelter wood, and seed tree cutting. Clear cutting removes all trees over 1 inch tall. Shelter wood removes 40 to 60% of trees at once. And seed tree cutting leaves a few well-spaced seed trees available. So this allows for our trees to be at an even age with one another. Selection management occurs when we have growth of trees in three or more age groups, allowing for continuous growth and harvesting. Harvesting methods include group selection and individual selection. Group selection removes trees from areas of 2 acres or less, whereas individual selection removes selected trees throughout the forest. And I have a nice little video there that you can watch that explains how selection management works. Now we get into the differences between private and public forests. Private forests are owned by individual people, and that's when the owner gets to decide how they manage their trees and their forests. The majority of land, or the majority of forests in the United States, are actually owned by the private sector, so people like you and I, or maybe some small businesses. So it's important that we provide incentives and education to people who own trees and own forests to make sure that they are managing them properly. Public forests is very controversial as well, because although it's owned by the government and it's public, we all have different opinions on how natural resources should be managed, as we talked about in class. So people question the following things. Should we preserve native timber forests? How much timber should be harvested at a time or in general? How does cutting affect our ecosystems and the different creatures that inhabit our trees? And how can we sustain forests for the future use? So there's a lot of discussion and debates going on between how we manage public forests. So again, private forests make up the majority of the land here in the United States. That's when the owner decides, may or may not be properly managed. Public forests, the government or the public manages those areas, but it's also very controversial in how we manage them. I have a nice little brain break in here too about Smokey the Bear. Some of you guys have probably heard of Smokey the Bear and that organization, or that social movement, I guess is probably the right term for that. But Watch that video if you have some time and kind of see how that relates to forestry. It's actually a pretty nice little clip that I've shown every class I've taught. So this is going to lead us into our next assignment, which we're going to pause here for now. We'll pick up here on our next video. But if you have any questions on the management techniques I've outlined so far, please feel free to send me an email or reach out. Thanks, guys.